I as well as the Chinese obese, and there he is.
Yo, yo, good morning.
Man of yesterday. Remo, how you doing?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you? Feeling better, mate?
A lot better, yeah. I mentioned in chat already, I slept 17 hours yesterday.
That was a good day.
That was indeed a good day. Oops, there you are.
Too bad you didn't, we're unable to see the movie of Warcraft yesterday. I went and saw it, but, well, let's hold on to the discussion for a later time when you've seen it as well.
Okay.
Lots of shit to talk about, though, man. Lots of stuff.
Yeah, you wrote me that yesterday, and I'm pretty curious. Seems like you're not that excited.
I thought, all right, as I said, we're going to get into this at a later point when you've seen it as well. I thought it was decent, you know, but many flaws. Which is not something, honestly, we're used to from Blizzard. But especially as a Warcraft fan, I think it's still worth watching.
All right. Yeah, I'm curious. I'm very, very curious. But I'm even more curious for the director's cut.
Yeah.
Whenever this will arrive.
Especially in the beginning of the movie, you could definitely feel that it was rushed.
Okay.
But I don't think that's where it really falls short. But yeah, let's postpone that discussion for another time. Today is going to be a different day, not for the Warcraft film discussion, but rather for our last day of the WCA coverage, WCA China qualifier number 2, and the last day of our 7-day marathon.
Oh, yes.
7 days straight, we've been casting in the mornings for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully we'll have some more soon. But yeah, we're coming to a close here. Yeah, today's going to be the last day for at least, you know, a few days.
Indeed. What a group stage it was, man. The first day especially, a day of upsets here. ZDR losing to TH and Infi losing to Colorful. On the other side, we had Romantic beat Fly 2-0. Yumiko, the only one of the favorites who was able to beat their opponents 2-0 here. Second day, ZDR beat Colorful, and no, that's wrong, right? Colorful beat ZDR. Oh no, ZDR beat Colorful.
ZDR yeah, beat exactly. Colorful, yeah.
And Infi beat TH. That's when everybody ended up with one win and one loss, and we had kind of finals yesterday. ZDR lost to Infi 2-0 and TH won against Colorful 2-0. So the Human Brothers on top of Group A.
Yeah, that was the... Well, I guess if we ignore the last qualifier, that is definitely what we were expecting. And the big story here from Group A, in my opinion, is TH really playing well again. He wasn't able to win against Infi, but apart from that, he was playing way better than I've seen him in a while. And, of course, ZDR way, way underperforming.
Yeah, one of the worst stats here, 2-5, only beaten by Fanta Fiction with a clean 0-6 in Group B. That was not his qualifier, losing every single game, not able to achieve one map. On the other side, Romantic beating Fly. Of course, he had a little upper hand because he received a death win for one map, but still managed to take a map off of Fly and then lost to Yumiko. But since Yumiko lost yesterday to Fly 2-0, he is out. He will be able to participate in qualifier number 3, but the playoffs without Yumiko.
Precisely. So that's a big surprise. Probably also Yumi getting very unlucky there that Fly was late and Romantic was given the death win. Because if Romantic had not received the death win, a 2-0 for him against Fly honestly would have been very unlikely. And then all of this might be looking a little different. But hey, that's how things go. But as it stands anyways, we have 3 big names and Romantic in the playoffs. And we still have to keep remembering only 10 slots at the WCA main event later this year. And only 1 slot for the qualifiers. So only one of those 3 names will get through. Or maybe Romantic, but that would be a big surprise. And after that, there's only going to be 1 more qualifier. So there's lots of fan favorites, or at least lots of... Yeah, favorites from their playstyle and from their strength in China, but many, many, many of them will not be going towards the main event later this year.
Indeed. For the top 4 that we have here already, Yumiko, Infi, Fly, and TH, 2 out of those 4 will not qualify for the grand final. That is a bummer, but since the list of participants is down from 16 to 10. This is what we get. And of course, they will meet with Lalight and Lin from Korea, two players from Europe, and two players from North America as well. Plus the one wild card, which will most likely go to Moon.
Yep. Everything else would be a big surprise. Yeah, and today we are starting with... What are we starting with, actually?
Fly versus Infi. The first semifinal, man. It's still a best of three.
Right on, man. I don't know if you watched the games yesterday by Fly versus Yumiko, but holy shit, did he play strong again. He oftentimes didn't have the best early game, but he smashed those tower rushes, man. It was incredible. He had a time when he was almost unbeatable by tower rushes. Then he kind of lost his groove and lost his swag, I guess, where he definitely fell to a few tower rushes again. But yesterday, even though Yumiko, in part, had great, like, fantastic early games, it didn't matter. He delayed, seriously, on that map, on a one map, he delayed the shop of Fly until the Shadow Hunter was out. Then the shop was still not up, and he still didn't manage to win. That's it. Incredible. It was really crazy, man.
Yeah, I saw the games, and it's been something, man. Fly is showing why he's the juggernaut. Fly is showing why he's the world champ and why he won GCS. Will Infi stand a chance against this Beastmaster? We'll see about that. And the game starts. For the first time, NetEase in English, everybody. And it, well, I used the 7 hours that I was awake yesterday after 17 hours of sleep. And yeah, turned my NetEase into English so we don't have to deal with the Chinese letters anymore.
All right, so we can also see items on the ground, which is nice.
Yep.
All right, Echo Isles map number one. We've seen a lot of different creep routes from the humans here. We have seen a lot of different play styles. Very aggressive tier level 2 Archmage aggression, or delay your aggression a bit, get level 3, but then very dedicated with a Beastmaster. A big story here, of course, is again going to be how fast is the tech, and if the Orc does tech fast, how much damage does he take in his main, and, you know, has a bad start anyways because he has few grunts.
Indeed. This is, by the way, the regame of the GCS quarterfinal. The two WCA winners meet each other. Infi, the winner of 2014. Fly, of course, the current reigning and defending world champion he is. In GCS, seemed to be an easy pick for Fly, to be honest.
That is true. And I think that back then he didn't even... Or back then, was only a few days ago lol. But those days ago, he didn't even seem to be as good as he was against Yumiko. Seriously, yesterday, what he performed on those maps against Yumi was a sight to behold. And especially because, you know, he didn't have a very good early game. Sometimes he had a bad early game. And still, how convincingly he smashed down those tower rushes, man. If Infi saw those games, if I was Infi, I would be very, very afraid. Because he saw, all right, good... Early game for Yumiko, this should be a win. Nope, didn't work. Alright, maybe it was just a one map thing. Next map. Alright, even better early game. This should certainly be a win for Yumiko. Nope, Fly still holds it easy. So, maybe Infi still goes for the tower rush, but I could definitely see him not going for that strategy because Fly at the moment just seems to be too good against it.
Exactly. He saw Yoss playing at WCA. He knows that there's a tactic that can beat his opponent today, and that is without towers. Maybe some for distraction stuff, but it was the area of effect combo that killed Fly in the end with Blizzard and Flamestrike. Infi seems not to be the biggest Blood Mage player that I've ever seen, even in mirror matches. Not too often that we see him pick this hero, but that could be an opportunity for Infi.
Yeah, we also saw the MK being successful. With, you know, map control, get level 2, level 3, fairly early, contest the orc, but traditionally that is not the way that the humans from China like to play, but maybe against the current Fly, who is so powerful against Tower Rush, that is something you may want to do. And also what I think is important here, I could also imagine that these players would like to feel each other out, you know, go for a Tower Rush and see, alright, you're really strong against the Tower Rush, I guess I don't do it then. But there's not many maps here to feel out your opponent, because it's only a best of three, and it's single elimination. If you drop down here, there is no lower bracket, you are just out. And Infi is doing what we saw doing him against CDR yesterday, going for the fast expansion, something that is very rare nowadays. The Grunt scouts this. ZDR was trying to apply some pressure yesterday, but honestly, was not doing it too well. How well can Fly do it? He went for the one borrow tech, so he's not he doesn't have many grunts at his disposal to harass this. And the Blade Master is not level 2, has a nice inventory though. This will have to be some very good control from the Orc if he wants to deal a lot of damage here.
But we know that Fly's Blade Master control is just off the charts crazy. Infi is calling more militia already to get this up and get the towers up. But the first res nicely saving that peasant here. Can he save the second one as well? Doesn't look like it. Nope, first blood on Echo Elves here. The Grunt has to be microed away. Yeah, we mentioned it, Fly. It may be the best Blade Master in the world, and that is the state for years. Even when he was back in Mouse Sports, he seemed to be the superior Blade Master player to Grubby, to Lin, to all the greats, great orcs that we have seen. And yeah, step for Infi, getting out of that situation, buying some time for towers. Of course, he needs towers, especially the Arcane Tower, to burn the mana, to get rid of the Windwalks, and then some Guard Towers as well for the damage. You see the Creeping Hero Fly, very risky play, but seems to be sufficient here. Not enough damage for Infi. He heals up, and the tech is on the way, almost finished already.
And this is a new opportunity, especially on Echo Isles, that presents itself to the humans. The expansion. If you know that the Orc is going for the one Borrow Tech, he's only going to have one Grunt for the longest time. If he has more, you're going to have a super hard time keeping your expansion alive. Also, specialty about Echo Isles, Orc has a tough time getting to level 2 very, very quickly. For example, if you face level 2 and like 2 or 3 grunts right away, there's probably no way you can keep that expansion alive. But this being Echo Isles, this being the specialty of the creep camps and stuff here, there is this possibility. But the big thing is, the Archmage is gonna be level 2 forever. Arcane Tower now up, Blade Master and Grunt, only one though attacking it. He's nicely blocking the second Grunt, which is pretty damn cool. And now the Blade is actually surrounded! Oh, shit, man. This might just be too much already. The Blade Master will be falling here. Is he going to be giving the experience over? Yes, he is. And this Archmage might just be finding level 2 way sooner than he thought. By the way, beautiful building positioning by Infi here at his expansion. Yeah. Making this kill possible and also making it tough before for his opponent to kill the peasants. Well, Fly great with his Blade Master, but sometimes he loses him in silly fashion.
Yeah, it's exactly what we say about Shishi, that he's kind of an acrobat. Sometimes he takes the biggest risks and loses his first hero. That's of course not what you want to happen. Level 2, that's gonna take some time for Fly to come back and harass, and that's of course the time for Infi to get to level 3. Finishing the Merc Camp here, we get a Ring of Protection, which is nice in the creeping phase. And yeah, level 3, level 2 Water Elemental arrived. And yeah, I think the tech has started. Yes, the tech has started. We see a Lumber Mill for Guard Towers. And everything looks good for the Iceman Infi. Shadowhunter is out on the field, though. He can creep him up very easily. But the Archmage comes in for the last hit. Nah, it's a little too late. Spawning the Water Elemental, harassing a bit, keeping the Shadowhunter low. So maybe he has to use that last heal wave. Not here, not on the grunts, but on himself. And the Boots of Speed have been stolen by the Archmage as well. So Infi's early game, pretty tremendous.
Yeah, this is as well as it can go against an Orc with a fast expansion. I mean, he lost 2, maybe 3 peasants. That's all. And he killed the Blade Master. So this game is going marvelously well for Infi. Now question is, Fly, what does he want to do? Does he want to attack the expansion, pressure it, get more resource out of his opponent? Can he possibly break it? I don't know. I don't think so. Another opportunity here in Echo Isles is creep the rest of the map. You have the stronger army. You have map control. And then try to counter expand, and hopefully you are not too late. What is Infi's place gonna be? His footmen are parked towards the north. 7 of them. To harass. I imagine they have defend already. Nope, not yet. It's finishing right now, and after it is finished, he's probably going to be going for the burrows, and maybe the Archmage will be scouting for the expansion at the meantime. As we see, well, it's not a peon actually. It is a raider moving downward, and we also see a witch doctor already for sentry wards, so it seems like he wants to be going for the late game here. Does he really have the time to do that though against 2 bases?
First he has to fend off this push from Infi with level 3. Footmen are doing a great job, Water Elemental of course as well. Repair is coming in. What's Fly reaction to this? First taking care of this Water Elemental here. And the first Burrow is down. Fly is supply stuck at the moment. He's going for the Archmage. Is kind of trapped, but gets him away. And the second Burrow seems to be holding here. The Peons are doing a good job repairing. There are a lot of resources to repair for the next minute or so.
First and look at this. The SH is setting up the expansion down there, and he's patiently waiting, defending the expansion with the SH. And the Blade Master is supposed to deal with all of this just by himself and, well, I guess one Raider and one Walker. And this seems very risky, like he might be taking too much damage here, but I like the thinking. He thinks, alright, I have to keep this expansion alive. I know he's gonna try to do a two-pronged attack. And even if I take damage here in the main, I have to defend my expansion. This is crucial. But is he gonna be able to? Lots of damage coming out from the Archmage and the Water Elemental. Is there Ensnare? I don't think so.
We saw the Ensnare, yeah, and there it is again, and it won't be enough damage to kill the Expo. In the meantime, the Water Metal is still doing something nice, Ethereal Form move by Fly, saving that so important Spirit Walker, but he lost two Burrows. He will be supply stuck for quite some time. It costs a few resources, and what can Infi do in this time? How can he capitalize? The expansion is up and running. Tier 2 is finished. He's going for the Mountain King once again. Double, triple Arcane Sanctum.
Yeah, exactly what we saw against ZDR yesterday as well. ZDR did not lose his Blade Master yesterday, but I believe his expansion was later. But yeah, the harass, as you said, in the main base was pretty substantial. Two Burrows lost. He is recreating them right now, but for the time being, he is supply stuck. And Infi, man, sitting at so much gold already, he is going to be able to churn out those units so fast. And the Archmage still trying to look for the cancel. But I don't know if it's going to work. He's going to use the invul. He's investing heavily into this. But I don't think that the damage output is high enough. Sentry wards, very nice decision by Fly. Always knows when harassment is coming in. I love this Witch Doctor pick.
Yeah, it's so cheap and so quickly built. And it gives you so much information. And he was aware that this was coming. Most likely he faced that in games against Infi before. And he knew, alright, if I put down a ward here, I will always have the time to react. I will always be able to move my Blade Master to that very position and help defending. The Great Hall is up. And more Walkers and Raiders are coming. The update is finished. And so we have Ensnare now. Second Barracks.
Interesting. He wants to go into mass grunts. Huh. Or demolishers, which also could be a choice here, but usually they really only seem to work well against towers. Maybe if you have a massive army, maybe then they become powerful. By the way, I like this positioning by Fly. He wants to take the fight to the human before he has 70 supply. And he hits level 3 on the SH right here, so he has a good power spike. He doesn't want to have to deal with this massive, massive human army. He wants to be trading right now and also be delaying an attack on his expansion. And for now, there are not many Spirit Walkers, Spellbreakers, excuse me. So Spirit Link can still be put to good use. Speed Scroll, get out of there after he took a few kills. I think he got two footmen and a sorceress, something like this, and lost nothing. So apart from this one Blade Master loss, I think this is really good. But now he sticks around for the single footman and the Blade Master, not again! Oh, Fly, you're playing this so well, but you're not supposed to lose your blade that often.
Fly is playing with fire and he gets burned here. Oh boy, what a big opportunity now for Infi. He will be up at 64 food in just a second. Blade Master is back. That cost a lot. Level 3.
Oh no.
Hero
oh no.
Uh-oh. There's no mana, but there was a Stormbolt actually.
Yeah, he could have tried to go for the surround there. I think that was just Infi for once not being quick enough on his feet. He probably was only thinking about the items. Like, crap, 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 I want the items. And didn't think about the surround there.
Alright. Because shop control on Echo Alt is very important, by the way. And here comes Infi's police. The militia support.
Triple heal scroll on Infi, man. This. Wow. 70 supply. So he has a more than 10 food advantage. And a triple heal scroll advantage. This fight is not supposed to be winnable at all for Fly.
That's true, but he has a good blade master, two claws and a gloves of haste. No invul potion though, only a healing. And what can he do against this? There are a good amount of raiders, so Spirit Link will not be put to good use. He's going for the hero focus first. Nah, no. Leaves the Mountain King alone, catches the Stormbolt, tanking a lot of hits here. How much mana is on the SH? Two more heal waves most likely. A Kodo Beast is coming out, has to eat a breaker and then get out. Oh, snaps into nowhere. There it is. One grunt being microed away. Next heal wave is rattling through, but not for too much. Two grunts are about to die.
Alright, and the Orc reinforcements should be coming in. He's now finally able to spend all of his gold. He was supply blocked for a time being, but the damage is just not really there for the human. The water elementals have both been dispelled. They were sitting next to each other, and the MK is still not level 3. So this Blade Master with his massive inventory might just be able to fend off this attack again. This is not supposed to happen. This fight started with a 10-foot disadvantage. Now we're down to only about a 5-foot disadvantage. But the thing about the human army is it's not supposed to win immediately. It's supposed to bleed dry the orc over time. And now here we see the pickoffs coming. One grunt, two grunts, three grunts. They're falling one after the other, getting the MK closer to level 3. And we're back at a 10-foot disadvantage. It might just be more in a second as Infi is moving forward. And there's not going to be internal healing.
That's right, and the Blade Master has to be so super duper careful. There will be a Stormbolt very soon, and then a surround is possible because there is no mana anymore.
Oh, he's trying to go for it.
Yeah, there we go. Oh boy, he's surrounded. He is surrounded. One last heal wave, and that should be it. No mana at all, and the Blade Master, will he die for the third time? Yes! The blade was sharp, but not sharp enough. It's GG! By Fly, and after 14 minutes, Infi is taking the first map.
All right, this was very well played by both players, not just micro-wise, mechanically-wise, but also strategy-wise, I feel. Going for the expansion on Echo Isles, again, probably only possible on this map, against the One Borrow tech. Very good choice by Infi. Also, it's going to make Fly think twice about going for the One Borrow tech, and this might open up opportunities for an easier tower rush. Coming on another map, like Last Refuge, where maybe, though, an expansion might still be possible. But Flyman playing it really well, knowing what he has to do. He has to counter-expand, he has to keep the expansion alive, he has to creep, he has to use map control. That is a lot of things to all be doing at the same time. That's why we saw the Witch Doctor. I think the coolest thing in this match. He plays Sentry Wards early on, he knows his army is strong enough, he can afford to use that 2 supply to just, you know, for vision. It doesn't fight, it's just there for vision, but he can afford to do it. And then he splits up his army, Blade Master deals with the Footman Harass, and the reinforcements deal with the Footman Harass as well. SH tries to keep the expansion alive. Very well played by Fly, but again, the one thing bringing him to his knees, as it is so often, he loses his Blade Master too much.
Exactly. Will this be one of those days where Fly's performance throughout the event is quite stellar, except day one maybe, and now he falls off a cliff? We've seen this so many times.
It's too early to say that, though. He made, of course, big mistakes with the Blade Master, but I think, seriously, apart from the Blade Master losses, this was pretty damn close to perfect, I would say.
Well, it was 3 Blade Master losses, so that's quite a statement. The next map is going to be Last Refuge.
Yep, it is. So again, very easy expansion for the human to take. It's also hard for the orc to find a fast level 2. So that is pretty much the same as on Echo Isles. But the thing here is, it's very much so closer towards your opponent's main, which is an issue. And also, mercenary support will be way harder to secure. We didn't see the mercenaries come into too much play or to become too important on map number 1. But if the orc decides to go for a lot of pressure instead of counter-expanding, you really want those mercenaries.
True that. We saw it work so many times, especially the berserkers for the damage. Okay, they're asking if everybody's ready. Infi is switching his color. And yesterday you experience what a pain in the ass it is when the players change all the time.
Yeah, but here we go. I think they're intentionally messing with the, with the broadcast.
Alright.
Okay, I think psychologically now Infi has an advantage as far as strategy goes, because Fly thinks, alright, crap. this guy plays fast expansion. I saw him playing it against ZDR, but I thought that was just because he knows that he's better than ZDR, or at least he thinks he does, you know? So against him, he can pull it off, but maybe not against me, because we haven't seen it much, because it can be punished really hard. So now Fly has to think, okay, do I go two Burrow at two Burrow tech exactly? Have more grunts? Then it's going to be really hard to pick up an expansion for Infi. But if I go to Burrow Grunt tech, then it's going to be pretty bad against a Taurush. So it's kind of flies stuck in an awkward coin toss here. And regardless of what he does, it might be bad. So it's going to be really interesting to see for what build he goes and what build Infi decides to go for as well.
Yeah, he positions the Alta close to the bottom lane, of course, to creep a little faster. Not too much to say here, but I think the distance between the two bases is quite far, so maybe an early tower push is not that great here on LR.
And we see it quite a bit though on LR. There's a few weird things here on LR. For example, you can pull the creeps of the Goblin Lab towards the towers, and the towers shoot at him, and the creeps come out. And then the human thinks, what the hell, man? What is this? This is not supposed to be happening. And also the way this base layout is designed by Fly, the towers will have to come up next to the forest and, you know, not too close to the Orc main. So probably the first few towers that come up will not be able to shoot at the Great Hall. Almost definitely will not be able to. So if a tower rush comes, it is going to be late. Now, we just saw fast expansion by Infi. We also saw one yesterday from him, but that was Echo Isles. Best map for fast expansion. Can he do it here as well? He has one map advantage now, so he can afford to lose here. So I could definitely see him trying to go for the tower rush here for the, you know, fairly cheesy, fairly easy win. But, you know, if he loses, that's okay. Fly is, after all, the best defender of tower rushes in the world. If he loses, that's okay. He still has a map, and that map will be his choice. Or is he going to try to go for the Expo again? And where is the Blade Master going? The Footman wants to know this as well. Scouts him. Blade Master, look at this. Not going for the creep. Going on the offensive right away. He says, all right, you want to go for a fast Expo? I'm going to show you this time what I can do with my blade.
Indeed. And Infi is going for the fast Expo, creeping the Ogre Magi. But the Blade Master is coming a little too late, though. Circled for the Archmage, but First Peasant is down immediately. Can he steal the little Trapper? No, he's focusing on the peasants as one should be. Too late for the last hit because he had to turn around, unfortunately, for Fly. But two peasants are hurt. That's a lot more backstabs. First one down. The Grunt joins the fray, gets the last hit. Oh, wow, this is a killing spree for the Blade Master here.
And that is why fast expansion is bad against Orc. If he commits to aggression early on, you're gonna take a lot of damage, and there's not really anything you can do about it. Now surrounding the Grunt, though, this is really nice from Infi, but the Archmage might just be taking a lot of damage. Don't lose your blade again. He opens up the surround. Grunt gets away. Blade Master is sticking around here. I'm fearing for his safety once again. By the way, we have the two Burrow tech this time. The shop, though, is very delayed, and the Blade Master denies himself to the creeps. Is he gonna buy him back from the tavern? No way, right?
I was thinking the same, but no, he's buying him back from the altar. It's not too much, and I think running back, healing up costs a lot more time than just buying him back. The shop is not finished as well. So this is some time for Infi now to get his expansion up. But the Grunts are doing a good job so far. He has to be careful not to be surrounded here. That would be a nice experience boost for the Archmage. But no, Fly is splitting the units. Oh, can he get a block out? No, Infi too slow with his units. So both Grunts will get away. But the expansion is up and coming. Blade Master's back, immediately going for the shop for heal selves, and here we go again, I guess.
Heavy investment into all those consumables. How many grunts do we have? Three still available, one being healed up right now, and this is a lot of damage potential from the Orc army. The Archmage would love to cancel some of the healing, by the way, with a Wand of Illusion. You can also cancel the healing, and we wake up the creeps, as we saw here. Now, boots on the Blade Master, not far from level 2. He has the circlet, he has three grunts. This is pretty much the best army you can have here in the early game, unless the Blade Master was level 2. Where's the Archmage, by the way, buying the Boots of Speed? He's not at his expansion, and again, he's going to be far away from level 3 again for a long time, unless maybe, you know, a Blade Master kill happens again. But let's hope that doesn't happen for the sake of Fly. Two peasants fall here once again. I think that's a grand total of 5 peasants dead now, and more will be falling as well. Level 2 right now for the Blade. the Archmage arrives. Of course, boots on him keep him alive, but these grunts still a threat. Blade Master trying to look for one more peasant and will surely find it and gets out of there. No, we'll have to use a Windwalk, but will survive. And all right, this expansion is up, but he has taken so much damage, man. He has taken so much damage, and tier 2 is available for Fly. Bit of a supply block here happening for him, but it will be resolved in a second. Of course, Bestiary, Spear Lodge coming up, and the SH soon to follow as well. He's weirdly standing at the tavern. Maybe a neutral hero, that would be crazy, though.
Naga, maybe?
That would be such a heavy commitment. I think Fly's in a good position this game, even if there is an expansion, that he doesn't need to like all in like this. I think he can just try to play the standard, either pressure more or counter-expand. I think both options are viable, especially since the Archmage is still only barely level 2. So I think Fly, playing this patiently, playing this well, adjusting very nicely to this fast expansion style.
So far, at least. But how fast will Infi get his units up, get his 70 supply death ball up? We'll see about that. Nice movement on the grunt, not getting surrounded here. No pickups for the Archmage, not getting closer to level 3. Same cannot be said about the Blade Master with the help of the grunt. He steals some creeps off of Infi.
Yeah, getting this is so good, man. This is so good. He keeps the Archmage busy with two grunts. He doesn't lose him. It was close. He almost lost one, but doesn't. So he keeps the Archmage from creeping. He keeps him low. And at the same time, he manages to find some experience on the Blade Master and takes away that creep camp, which can be taken by Militia only, where the Archmage doesn't even have to be. So I think Fly playing this beautifully. I wonder, though, what is the late game strategy going to be? Because he has to react to this expansion, even if he is playing this very well. Even if he is doing a lot of damage and... yeah, adjusting very, very nicely. The expansion will win in the end if he doesn't do anything about it. He has to pressure more, deal more damage, or counter-expand. And that's why Footman is parked next to the natural of the orc already. And so far there is no such attempt. For now, we see a little bit more creeping from Fly.
Indeed. Oh, Flute of Accuracy for Infi. One of the best items he could find. Damage boost for the entire army. But can you imagine a Book of the Dead now? That would be... absolutely amazing. Oh, heal stone also pretty damn nice. Almost level 3 for the Blade Master, and then level 2 Windwalk, obviously. He comes the first Spirit Walker, and Spirit Link is available. Infi needs a reaction. He started his tech only now. That's gonna take some time. Only one tower up at the expo. Easily killable so far with a good amount of raiders. Footman dies here. Don't shoot the messenger, but he does.
Alright, and now it's really time to decide for Fly. Does he expand now or not? Because if he expands later, it's most likely gonna be too late. And by the looks of it, he is not interested in expanding at all. You can also play with one base against two if you have a big advantage. If you have a massive hero advantage, if you take units out of your opponent's army and don't lose any of them yourself. If you trade very, very favorably. And for the time being, that is the case. Fly has not lost a single unit this game, and thank God, not a Blade Master as well. So, and he keeps on creeping. SH is getting closer to level 3. In fact, we'll reach it right here already before... no, actually, the Archmage is level 3 as well. And the Blade Master man again playing with fire.
Yeah, but he got two footmen out of this harass. They were pretty bad hurt on the Archmage side. He wasn't aware that the Blade Master is around. So he got two footmen for a Windwalk, and that is, of course, the trade you want. Water Mental Scouting now, additional experience, and both Heroes of the Orc are level 3. He's getting ready for a push. 48 food it is, more scouting from Infi, more cancelling of healings, and he's going for some kind of counter-aggression. Getting a heal scroll once again. We saw this at game number 1, going for the Burrows. Oh, Fly was pulling peons already, and the Kodo Beast. But now he has to defend first.
Alright, looks like he's gonna lose one Burrow. Not that painful, because he's basically at 50 supply already anyways. And he's going for a Demolisher offensively to pressure the expansion. That's where the peons were supposed to go as well, to repair that one Demolisher. And cheers, mate. As you're opening a can of cola. And this aggression was not too successful. I don't think it was designed to be very successful, to do a lot of damage, but more to get information and to keep back the orc. And this is a very unusual orc strategy, to pressure the expansion of the human with demolishers. Basically, we only see undeads doing that with tier 3 meat wagons and what is it called? Disease Cloud. But an orc doing it? Very rare. By the way, pillage coming in as well. How good is this pressure gonna work? So far, there are no tier 2 units. Speaking of which, Arcane Sanctums are coming up right now in the main base of the human. But there are demolishers who can be good if they are well protected. Alright, here we go. Spirit Link and the attack commences.
To that in the same time, Infi is putting some pressure towards Fly's base again, but what's it worth? The shop is down already, the first farm is up, is down already. Infi on 1,000 gold, but not too much lumber here. The Demolisher is doing a great job against the building so far. Archmage trying to save his expo with Water Elementals, but there's Dispel. He goes back just a little, he sees alright. Militia support is coming in, Mountain King is coming in, so against Stormbolt, this is a lot harder. And now, he even puts up some towers, he returns the favor. He has endured tower pushes from human players for years and years and years, and now it's his time.
Has to put them very far forward though, a little bit awkward here. I feel he would like to have him a little bit further back, but there is the river, there's water, so you can't build there. Little unfortunate, I guess, the map design here for the orc. Alright, this is one demolisher. This is not the end of the world. Peasants can definitely repair against this. When it becomes two, when it becomes three, that's when it gets really dangerous. But does he want to commit to so many? It doesn't look like it. No more are coming. In the meantime, by the way, footmen, I don't know why I said peasants, harassing the peons, and here comes the militia support, wants to try to get rid of the siege. By the way, we do have a second demolisher, but it's really hard to keep that alive against water elementals repair at the moment, not being used by the peons. Fly maybe a little unused to the situation, really needs to repair those demolishers badly. The fight of the rest of the army is going well, but everything is starting to drop low here as well.
Yeah, that's of course thanks to Spirit Link. He's getting a few hits here. Nice end snare on the Berserker. Down he is. Level 4 on the Blade Master. Critical strike level 2. And Infi is forced into a town portal back to his main base to heal up, I guess. Is there a shop for him? He lost the one at the expo. No shop for Infi. He had one regen scroll. So you can use that and come back. Fly setting up towers again. But yeah, the first time in a long time we see his micro and macro struggling. Look at the base of Fly. There's so many corpses here thanks to the peons. His economy is heavily struggling, but that's of course okay if he can keep the expansion down and tear the expansion down. But the question is, can he do that? 66 versus 45. Fly is definitely struggling with this push. Blade Master is down to half HP. Has to use a heal speed scroll to get out of there. Everything is hurt and he retreats there. And now what's left? Nice, Stormbolt gets that walker. Yeah, what can he do? With a crippled economy and Infi has superior numbers as well.
Hey man, these two footmen actually making such a big difference. I can't believe it. Only two footmen may be deciding the game here because this attack has been held and now the orc forces are dying one by one. I think Infi's just done it. I think Infi is defeating the world champion two maps in a row with fast expansion. As we can see, more and more units are falling, and that's it! GG, Infi takes out Fly in the semifinals of the playoffs.
In a game that lasted 13 minutes and 37 seconds, by the way.
But Fly was playing it so well. Why didn't he just do it like he did on Echo Isles? Go for the late game. Expand yourself. Force the human to attack into you. I think that was the wrong strategy. Going for the attack on the expansion.
Yeah. He was heavily committing, and I think it was already too late for a push like that. And that was, of course, due to Infi pushing a little earlier with his footman, with his archmage, scouting that catapult. And anyway, okay, there's going to be some pressure. I'm going to do the best I can to relieve that pressure with some footmen, and that worked just absolutely beautifully. So, yeah, well-deserved win for Infi. And it is, once again, like in the NWL final against Yumiko, Infi is starting to adapt here. He had his tactics for years, I felt, Tower pushes versus Org, fast expansion versus basically everything else. And now he's switching things up at least to a degree, and that works good well for him.
Yeah, absolutely. Seeing how Fly just demolishes Tower Rushes recently, going for the fast expo, Echo Isles, obviously the best map for this. But Fly, Echo playing so well, but there was the stupid Blade Master losses, and then Last Refuge, he felt he had such a good early game, he could just kill the expo, but all the undeads out there, like myself, know human expo is really tough to kill. Orcs nowadays don't seem to be knowing that as much anymore. Had he gone for a fast expansion with the sentry wards again, this would have been a vastly different game, but he felt he could break it. Well, turns out even a world champion can be wrong. So unfortunately he is out, and he will have only one chance remaining, one opportunity, Mom Spaghetti, to be getting to the grand final again later this year. And we continue with our next match of today's qualifier. It's going to be Romantic versus TH, a human mirror, obviously. And here we have to say, just from the names, we have a big favorite.
True that. TH, world champion of 2013, is playing here. In 2014, we were discussing, is he maybe surpassing Fly as the best human player of all time? Because he just won it all, but then Heroes of the Storm came up and he fell into a slum. But now he said, okay, Heroes is over for me. I'm focusing on Warcraft again. And yeah, his performance in GCS wasn't that great. But in this qualifier, I feel he's doing a little better at least. And so he is the favorite against Romantic here for sure.
I think yesterday especially he was playing really well against Colorful. So GCS, not his tournament. I don't know what it is with him. The performance yesterday really seemed better than usual. Maybe he needed this kick in the butt, but honestly, he's been getting kicked in the butt for quite a while now. If you're considering where he came from, back in 2012, when he was just, well, the force in the world, where he was the top of the game. He's not been there in a long time. He's still, I would say, far from that, but maybe he's getting closer.
True that. We see the grid one more time. Infi advanced due to a 2-0 versus a Fly. Who's going to be his opponent? Will the two human brothers meet each other in the final for the spot? Or is it the black sheep? Is it Romantic? We're going to answer this question after a little break. The Chinese are taking a break as well, so most likely 15 minutes. And we are back here at Back to Warcraft with the second semi-final of the day. TH versus Romantic coming up.